Now let's see about constants in C++ programming or literals in C++ programming. A constant refers to a value, a fixed value. So constant can also be called as literal also. So constant or literal means it contains some fixed value. Mainly in C++ there are four types of constants are available. The first one is integer constants. Integer constants. The second one is floating point constants. Floating point constants. Third one is character constants. Fourth one is string constants. So constant or literal means it contains a fixed value. Mainly we have four types of constants are available: integer constants, floating point constants, character constants and string constants. In this video we are going to discuss about all these constants. First one is integer constants. We know what is integer, okay? It contains a collection of digits from 0 to 9, okay? Integer constants are mainly classified into three types. The first type of integer constant is octal constant. Octal constant is nothing but base 8. The second type of integer constant is decimal constant. Decimal means base 10. Decimal means base 10. The third type of integer constant is hexadecimal constant. Hexadecimal constant. For hexadecimal constant, the base value is 16. First let's see what is octal constant. The name itself specifies the meaning. Octal constant contains a combination of digits from 0 to 7. So octal means base 8. So we can have 8 digits from 0 to 7. Okay. So octal constant always begins with 0. Let's take an example for octal constant. So 0th one. So this is nothing but an octal constant. 0, 8, 9. So 0, 12 is an octal constant. Why? Because it is beginning with 0 and it allows the numbers from 0 to 7. But coming to 0, 8, 9, this is not an octal constant. Why? Because an octal constant can accept the digits from 0 to 7 only. But here we have 8 and 9. So we can say that it is invalid octal constant. So what is octal constant? It contains digits from 0 to 9. So we can have digits from 0 to, we can have digits from 0 to 7. And octal constant always begins with 0. Now let's see about decimal constant. Decimal constant means we can have digits from 0 to 9. So that is nothing but decimal constant. It contains a combination of digits from 0 to 9. So if you take the number 78, so this is nothing but a decimal constant. If you take the number 95, so 9578, so this is also decimal constant. Why? Because here we have digits from 0 to 9. And the next one is hexadecimal constant. Hexadecimal constant allows the digits from 0 to 9 and A to F. A to F. 0 to 9 and A to F. Here A means 10, B means 11, C means 12, D means 13, E means 14, F means 15. So that means it allows digits from 0 to 15. But A means 10, B means 11, likewise F means 15. And one more rule for a hexadecimal constant. Hexadecimal constant always begins with 0x. Here the x value may be either lowercase or uppercase letter. The examples for hexadecimal constants are some 0x93f. So this is a valid. Why? Because what is hexadecimal constant? It starts with 0x and it allows the digits from 0 to 9 and from A to F. So this is about integer constants. Now let's look into the second type of constant, that is floating point constant. A floating point constant is mainly represented in two ways. Now let's discuss about floating point constant. It is represented in two ways. The first representation is fractional notation. Fractional notation. Whereas the second representation is exponential notation. So we can represent a floating point number in two ways: First way, fractional notation. Second way, exponential notation. Fractional notation means the corresponding number must have a decimal point. So before and after the decimal point, we can have some digits. Okay, it may be either positive number or negative number, there is no problem. So fractional notation means the corresponding number should contain a decimal point, and before the decimal point as well as after the decimal point, we must have some digits. Now let's see about exponential notation. In exponential notation, we can represent a number in this form, m into b power e, where m represents, m means mantissa value. Mantissa value may be either integer value or floating point number, there is no problem. Positive integer or negative integer or positive floating point number or negative floating point number, there is no problem. And the second one is b stands for base. Okay, if you don't specify any base value, then 10 will be considered as the base value. And the next one is e stands for exponent. Exponent, here exponent value must be an integer number only, it should not be the floating point number. Exponent value must be either positive integer or negative integer, but it should not be a floating point number. Now let's see some examples. So 10 into 10 power minus 5 210. So here 210 is nothing but mantissa value, this 10 is nothing but what is this 10 base value, this minus 5 is nothing but exponent value. Next let us take an example, 0.127 e minus 5. Here 0.127 is nothing but mantissa value, this e is nothing but base value. Okay, here base value is not specified, so in this situation we can consider base value as 10. So minus 5 is nothing but exponent value. So exponent value may be either positive integer or negative integer, but it should not be a floating point number. Okay, or in place of capital E, we can write small e also. So 23 e 5. So 23 is nothing but mantissa value, whereas 5 is nothing but exponent value. So this e is nothing but what? The base value. So what is the base now? Base is not specified. So 10 will be considered as the base. So in this example also, base is not specified. Exponent is minus 5. So base is not specified. In that occasion, we have to consider 10 as the base value. Here also exponent is specified. 5 is the exponent, but base is not given. So we have to consider 10 as the base value. So this is about floating point constant. Now let's see about character constant. Character constant means a single character which is enclosed in single quotation. It may be either alphabet or digit or symbol, there is no problem. So character constant means a single character which is enclosed in single quotation. So here the character means it may be either alphabet or digit or some symbol, anything. And the next one is string constant. String means a collection of characters which are enclosed in double quotations. We know that here the characters may be either alphabets or digits or symbols. So we can have any type. So RA129. So this is nothing but a string. So what is a string constant? We can have a collection of characters, but those characters must be enclosed in double quotations. So we can have, what are the characters? We can have either alphabets or digits or symbols. Let's take some Rahul. So this is nothing but a string. Let us assume that 4, 5, 6. This is nothing but a string. So dollar minus underscore. This is nothing but a string. Okay. So this is about constants or literals. So the integer constants are nothing but integer literals. Floating point constants are nothing but floating point literals. We can call these as character literals. We can call these as string literals. 10 is nothing but integer literals. 2.5 is nothing but floating point literal, like that. So this is about constants in C++ programming. Here we have one more topic, that is how to define the constants. We can define the constants with the help of some symbolic constants. We have two symbolic constants. First one is const keyword, whereas the second one is hash defined directive. So that we will discuss in the next video.